Whenever we draw a cell dividing, especially an animal cell, we know that there are a pair of centrioles present on the two ends of the cell, which we call poles, and they are responsible for making the spindle fibers. The same centriole are present as basal granules in organism which have cilia, and the base of the cilia or the flagellum, the basal granules, is nothing but a centriole. So what is this centriole and how are they related to these flagella and the cilia? That is what we are going to see today. So here I am making an organism with flagellum. Do you recognize what it is? Yes, it is Euglena. And see, at the base of this are these basal granules. So basal granules and these centrioles and the basal granules giving rise to the cilia are all the same thing. And the organization of flagellum, cilia, the exoneme part, is also done by the centrioles. So today we are going to see how to draw the centrioles, the ultrastructure, as well as the inner parts of cilia and flagellum and their ultrastructure. So first of all, we will need a scale, pencil, eraser, and so what are you going to do? You will make one line of 4 centimeters, okay, and draw an angle of 120 degrees on it. So second line 4 centimeters, and similarly another line at 120 degrees, and you have got 3 lines of 4 centimeters each with intervening angles 120, which means a full 360 angle is complete. So in a way, these are 3 radii of a circle with 4 centimeter radius. So either you use a compass or a set square, doesn't matter. Now next step is this. These 120 degree angles are to be further divided into 40-40 angle each. So 120 divided to 40 degree, 40 degree, and 40 degree. Every time the line should be of the same dimension, that is 4 centimeter. Similarly on these sides, 120 degree all divided into 3. So total we have got 9 sectors of a circle. You have not drawn the periphery. 9 sectors with 40 degree each, and the length of the line is 4 centimeter. Next step. Now draw lines joining the adjacent radii. Okay, comes roughly 3 centimeter. Now take the mid part of 3 centimeter, which is 1.5, and make a right angle on it. You can take 1 centimeter long line. So 90 angle on the midpoint of this line and 1 centimeter. Now next step will be, you are going to make small triangles using the end part of this line. So you are joining the two parts and you have got one more triangle. Similarly, you are going to make these triangles, complete all the triangles. I have rubbed off the lines, they all were at 1 centimeter. So draw all the triangles, and now with a free hand, just make these lines. Okay, from these ends, make curved lines, small curved lines but all of them in one direction. So they look like cartwheel. Already they are looking like cartwheel. So once again, friends, 9 sectors, triangles, another triangle on top of that, and you have drawn the curved line beginning with the each of the radii. Now you just have to complete this structure. Now what are we doing? We are making along these curved lines, you are making 3 circles A, B, C depicting the triplet fibrils which are made up of tubulin molecules, tubulin dimers. So you are making ABC 3 subfibrils, so they are called triplets. So we have got 9 triplets, and the central part you will rub off here. This part you have rubbed off and made a small circle depicting the central hub. This is also protein, central hub. Now you are going to make thickenings at these junctures, and you're going to join these junctures with lines joining A and C. This is C, so it should be A. So these are called CA linkers, and you are joining these thickenings with the CA linkers. So you have made CA linkers everywhere. So now this whole structure looks like a cartwheel. Cartwheel with 9 plus 0 arrangement of peripheral tubules. Each tubule is made up of a triplet. And now just dot off this all the whole area to show the pericentriolar region. This region is made up of the protein which will be nucleated, which will be organized by this centriole. Now this centriole actually looks like something like this. Okay, so if this is one centriole, then the second centriole would be lying at right angle to it, and inside this you will see these 9 peripheral fibrils with the central hub. So they will run throughout the length. Similarly here also, so 9 peripheral tubulets, and they run along the length. So here is lying one of them. Okay, one of them is lying here, while here they would be lying at right angle to each other. If one is like this, then other would be like this. So this is how you're going to draw the cartwheel like structure of the centriole. You can have a look. Triplet, how it is made up of tubulin units. Each of this has 13 subunits, 13 dimers of tubulin, and since there are 3 of them, they would be sharing 2 to 3 units between them. So first one will have complete 13, while others will have 2 or 3 less, and this is how they are arranged, the triplet.